have to deal with these people. And who nice to make them like, just because they're standing in the
I feel like it doesn't matter that we're both not in the 1%. Like, you know what I mean? It's like, yeah, we're both not super wealthy, but like, I already recognize that we're very different. And like, we come from different places and different identities and backgrounds. And like, the problem is that they don't recognize that. That they don't want to see, like, they're just like, yeah, we're all one big human family. Like, there's no race but the human race. You know what I mean? Like, it's fucking bullshit. And like, the problem is on them. It's not on us.
No, I don't know where I came from. I don't know my background. And you don't even care to know. That's not what I consider my family.
No, I don't consider my family. And I probably never would. But how do you use that energy and the privilege that they do have, which is slowly going away as they and they'll still have privileges, that's never going to go away. That's never going to go away. How do you use that to change? I don't have any answer. I'm just like, I want to know. You know, I want to know how to use that. And like, do you?
They have to be aware of their privilege and power so that they can.
Well, they have to read like what's so wrong. Where does it begin? Where does it begin? Okay. You start with like a knowledge privilege. Like, who did that? What is that? Macintosh? Macintosh. Knowledge privilege. And then we say, oh, how do you acknowledge privilege? Get over it. Acknowledge everyone's different. And move from there. Be sensitive to people. Make friends with people that you want to be friends with. Work on relationships. Work hard in your life to create lasting and sustainable relationships with people that you never would have thought you would make relationships with.
But
given us this amazing advice, everyone wants to say it's hopeless, and I do believe to some extent these people are hopeless because I see them and they're assholes and they're mean, but there's people that have been like giving this advice for so long, and it's like, okay, now I'm responsible for the work, but it's like, I don't know.
No. I don't feel responsible at all. I feel like tread upon. And like, I've been excluded. And I don't want to reach out again. You know what I mean? Like, I want to reach out to the people who I know are also like going through the same thing and who are like feeling the same way. But I don't know. I feel like the thing about it is that you can't just be like, you can't just tell people like, you really should examine your privilege. And then that's going to solve the problem. Like, they have to have this spark in them. Like, that's like, I have this and I need to confront it and I need to do the personal work. It's a personal thing. And it's like, you can't just, I don't know, like, I feel like there's ways to, like, facilitate it, like, through workshops and stuff, like, that's how I've kind of begun, like, my anti-racist path, you know what I mean, or, like, going on that journey in myself, but it's not, like, it's, I don't know, I would not claim that I have it figured out. And I feel like a lot of the people there are immediately like, kind of like taking this like politician stance where they're like, I totally get it. Like, I'm on your side, I totally get it. It's like, no, like, I just told you about this 2 seconds ago. Like, there's no way that you could have overcome all of the beliefs that you already have about this. You know what I mean? Like, they just want it to be, like, a quick fix, you know?
Yeah.
And it's not. So.
But I also believe that people are so resistant to being aware of these things because they haven't necessarily had an access point to understand. Like, a lot of people have different ideas. You have an access point into understanding everyone else because you know what it feels like to be alone. Or having experienced the best environment in life can even be like, it's just like so many people are just getting that.